10 to 10 is Preacher Prophet the Psychic coming back at you again with another video. Okay, what we have here, we got an interesting match, very good match, the matchup I always wanted here. We got Maria Sharapova versus my girl, y'all know, Simona Halep now. Okay, I'm in a bad situation, people, because y'all remember I took Naomi Osaka, and I had to come out and make an apology to my girl, Simona Halep. So I took Naomi, now I can't, so I'm in a bad situation. Like, I can't go against Simona Halep again, and if she win, I'm a little stupid. So now this is a rematch of the 2014 French Open Finals. Simona Halep versus Sharapova. Sharapova won, okay, in the third set. It was a really good match. And Sharapova was hitting some unbelievable shots right on the lines. You know how Sharapova be doing it. And so she won. It was a very good match, though. But now Simona Halep is much better. Let's see what she has to offer now, man. This is a totally different situation now. Okay, so who do I think is going to win this here? Wow, man. People, let me just get to the point here. Okay, I'm going to take Simona Halep to win this. Like, if somebody say put your money down, you got to put the money on either Simona Halep or Sharapova. I'm going to go with Simona Halep to win this. It could be 2, it could be 3. So, but now I'm going to add this, though. I'm going to add this as a little backup, people. I got this feeling, this gut feeling, if not doing the wrong, if that Sharapova is going to have a resurgence. It could be in the Rome, or it could be in the French Open. You remember I did a video yesterday, 2 days ago, saying that Sharapova is a top favorite to win Rome, a top favorite to win the French Open, because she's won the French Open before, and there's a lot of players that can't play as well on clay as they play on other surfaces. Of course, Simona Halep can, okay? So I just want to throw that out there. I mean, there's a possibility that Sharapova, this could be her true coming out party, that she's waited to be on the surface that she has been the most successful on as far as majors, and that's clay. So I'm going to just throw that out there, okay? But I'm going to take Simona Halep, though, to beat Sharapova here, okay? And I want to say something here. You know what? I was watching Simona Halep today. She looked so good on clay. For all y'all that started calling the team the Baby Nadal and the Prince of Clay, let me tell y'all who y'all should call the Princess of Clay. Let's let her win the French Open. Let's let her win Rome. But I think if if Simona Halep wins the French Open, I'm gonna call her the Princess of Clay. I'm not gonna call her Baby Nadal. I don't know about the Baby Nadal. She may not want to be called the Baby Nadal, but I think we could call her the Princess of Clay. She's not the Queen of Clay, but she could be the Princess of Clay. And she's playing. I'm looking at how Simona Halep is playing on the clay. She's playing. You know what I saw her playing today? She looked as good as Nadal. Like, if you compared a woman to, say, if we took the best man on clay, which is Nadal, and we took the best woman on clay, which is Simona Halep right now. Well, somebody could say, a Sharapova fan could say, well, Sharapova got more French Opens than Simona Halep, and Simona Halep doesn't have any French Opens yet. So somebody could make that argument that Sharapova should be called the Princess of Clay based on the majors. Okay, got you there. But I'm just talking about, if you ask me who looked more like a true clay courter, it's Simona Halep. The way she's playing on the clay now, the way she beat Naomi Osaka. See, Sharapova pretty well plays the same way she plays on clay, which is good, the same way she plays on grass. Just powerful driving, tough grunting ground strokes. But Simona Halep, it seems like she has a special game that she's designed for this clay, and it's coming out at a high level right now. Okay, people, so I got Simona Halep beating Sharapova, but like I did say, Sharapova could have a resurgence on clay. It's possible. Here at Rome, and she could possibly have a resurgence at the French Open, but we'll deal with that later. Okay, people, tennis preacher, prophet, psychic, signing off. Have a good one. Ha ha ha.